Bam! Mr. Taru, in this video, we are going to look at working out definite integrals or evaluating definite integrals involving integration by parts. In my full-length lesson where I introduced this concept, the link to that lesson is in the description of this video, everything was indefinite integrals. So if you happen upon your homework, the definite integral from a to b of u dv is going to be equal to, well, we're going to evaluate the product of uv using those lower limits and upper limits of a and b, minus the definite integral from a to b of v du. And if you did not see my full-length lesson on integration by parts, we want to identify the factor of the integrand, which when we take the derivative of it, we get a simpler expression, and that's going to be u. And the rest of the integrand, or the more complicated factor that will still be, where you can still integrate it using a basic integration rule, is going to be set equal to dv. Okay, so our example that we're going to look at is the definite integral of 0 from 0 to 1 of 3x times the inverse cosine or arc cosine of x squared dx. Now, what do you let equal u and what do you let equal dv? Well, in our full-length lesson, we were introduced to an acronym that would help us, and there's slight variations this you can find on YouTube or the internet or maybe even in your textbook, if it gives you one, to give you an aid to help identify what you want to set equal to u. And you go down in sequence and you look for either, first you look for logarithms and then inverse trig functions and algebraic expressions, a trigonometric function or factor, and then finally an exponential factor to your integrand. And whatever you hit first as you go down this acronym is a suggestion to what may be something good to set equal to u. So do we have any logarithms? No. Do we have any inverse trig functions? Why, yes we do. We have the inverse cosine or arc cosine of x squared. And so let's set that equal to u and see what we get as far as u, v, and du that we can plug into our integration by parts rule here and finish up the problem. Okay, so we're going to let u equal the inverse cosine of x squared. You put the dx portion to the rest of, you use the dx part of this integrand as you set up your dv equation. And if you're going to let u equal the inverse cosine of x squared, then du is going to be equal to, okay, the derivative of inverse cosine. That's u, negative u prime, or the opposite, yeah, negative u prime. So this is my u, or negative du, and so that's going to be negative 2x over the square root of 1 minus u squared. So the square root of 1 minus my inside function u squared dx. Okay, and then that's going to be equal to negative 2x over the square root of 1 minus x to the fourth for du. Okay, so if my u is going to be the inverse cosine of x squared, then my dv is going to be equal to the rest of that. And I can do this now or later. I'm going to go ahead and do this now. I'm going to take this constant that's in front of the x and move it out in front of my definite integral and have 3 times the definite integral from 0 to 1 of x times the cosine, inverse cosine, of x squared dx. And now my dv is going to be equal to x dx. And to figure out what my v is going to be, to go into this rule, of course, I just integrate this, and so v is going to be equal to the indefinite integral of, of x dx, which is going to give me, I'm going to take that power, increase it by 1. This is going to be x squared. I'm trying to write the symbol, and I'm also doing the integration at the same time. Of course, that's not what I really mean to do, so let's try that again. V is equal to the indefinite integral of x dx. Now, to actually integrate that, we get v is equal to, we're going to raise that power by 1. So we get x squared. We're going to divide by that raised power. So we're going to have 1 half x squared dx. Let's try that again. How about 1 half x squared? Okay, now that we have our u, our du, and integrating our equation that we set equal to dv, our expression for v, let's plug into this integration by parts rule and see where we stand. So we have our 3 times uv being analyzed with that lower limit of 0 and upper limit of 1 minus the definite integral from 0 to 1 of v du. And we're letting the 2's cancel out. I'm also, a lot of times when this numerator is negative, you could bring that constant, if you will, of negative 1 out front and let it cancel with that minus sign there. And I could have write plus the definite integral from 0 to 1 of x cubed over the square root of 1 minus x to the fourth. You'll see in a second why I left the negative there, though. I don't like to integrate with the, you know, with a radical sign in the expression, so I'm going to write that square root, of course, as a power of 1 half, and I'm writing it as a power of negative 1 half because I'm letting it float out of the denominator. And so as it stands now, we have 3 times the 3 times 1 half x squared times the inverse cosine of x squared with that lower limit of 0 and 1 that's going to be evaluated, I'm going to evaluate that with, minus the definite integral from 0 to 1 of negative x cubed times 1 minus x to the fourth to the negative 1 half power dx. Now, this definite integral that's left in the problem, you know, are we going to need integration by parts again to evaluate and do that integration? Or can we just, you know, use some kind of basic integration rule that we've studied already in the class? I mean, we've got a lot of integration rules, basic integration rules at our disposal. There's some kind of, there's something going on here with a power attached to it. So can we integrate using the power rule? Well, if I let this inside function be my u, or I've already used u, so let's say w. So we're going to let w equal 1 minus x to the fourth. Well, then if w is equal to that inside function 1 minus x to the fourth, then dw, taking the derivative, we're going to get negative 4 x to the third dx. And then I can see that, well, I have a negative x to the third, dx. So I can do a couple of things. In my early introduction and many of my lessons involving integration, I did a whole, I like to do the u substitution completely, but as we've moved more and more into our book, if you can just complete the chain rule and recognize that in your pattern that you're trying to use some kind of basic integration rule with, you can do that as well. So in other words, what I mean is, I can take this and I can divide both sides by 4. And I can now, with this u is equal to 1 minus x to the fourth, and with this equation here, 1 fourth dw equals negative x cubed plus or times dx, or excuse me, negative x cubed dx, it's not really times dx, but at any rate, I can rewrite this expression now, removing all references to x and rewrite it in terms of w. But then I'm going to have to change the lower and upper limits of my definite integration expression here, and you know, if I'm going to go into remove all references of x, then I can't have my lower and upper limits in terms of x either. I will need to have it in terms of w. So instead of going through all of that, I can just complete the chain rule. The chain rule meaning that if I could introduce a negative 4 here, then I would have my u to the power and my du out front, my chain rule will have been completed, and I can just, you know, finish with the integration rule, the power rule of integration. So I'm going to rewrite this as 3 times 1 half x squared inverse cosine of x squared. Lower and upper limits of 0 and 1 again. Now, I need a 4 to be there, so I'm going to have minus the definite integral from 0 to 1 of negative 4 x cubed times 1 minus x to the 4th raised to the negative 1 half power dx. So now inside my power I have a u, and my u prime is outside of that power, so I have the chain rule complete. But if I'm going to introduce a multiple of 4, I need to cancel that with a division of 4. And now, and I'm going to step off and reveal the solution one step at a time so you don't have to waste your time watching me write. But with that u and that u prime now, that chain rule complete, I can just integrate using the power rule and, you know, get to a final answer for this definite integral. Okay, so again, just one more time, remembering that now that we have a u and a u prime, the chain rule pattern completed, I can just use the power rule of integration. So we're going to take that power of negative 1 half, we're going to increase it by 1, we're going to divide by that increased power. But dividing by 2, of course, we know is the same as multiplying by 2. I can leave the 2 in these brackets or pull that constant multiple out front. So 2 times 1 fourth is equal to 1 half. And now start plugging in our lower and upper limits in each of these expressions. So we have 3 times 1 half times 1 squared times the inverse cosine of 1 minus 1 half times 0 squared times the inverse cosine of 0, and so on, just continuing that process through the rest of this line. And the inverse cosine of 1, of course, what angle measure gives you a cosine value of 1? 0. So this expression comes out to be 0 because the inverse cosine of 1 is 0, and then 0 times anything is 0. We have a factor of 0 here. We have minus 1 half. 1 minus 1 is 0, so that's going to be 0 again, minus the square root of 1, which is going to be 1. And cleaning this up, we have a final answer of 3 halves. And that is how you do a definite integral, or evaluate a definite integral, when you are going to need to use integration by parts. I'm Mr. True. Go do your homework.